Everything the same, the manhole is here. This is Mr. Matusiak, this case is well known to this court as well as many other members that are present in the court today. Mr. Matusiak suffered a great deal of loss in this matter. Not only did he lose his job where they refused to pay his retirement because of this conviction, he lost much of his family. His family was split apart. His wife attempted to commit suicide during the pendency of this. By doing so, she lost both of her arms. Mr. Matusiak is forced to look at that every day and realize that because of his actions, he has to live with that. His only source of income at this point is, in fact, her disability. He did attempt to start a car lot, which was unsuccessful with his son. So, Your Honor, I will indicate to you that he did receive some sort of lump sum to live off of, but it was enough to live approximately 1 year off of, which is gone now. All he has to live on is, as I indicated, disability from the wife and any other income that he can, in fact, garner up, although he does have to take care of on a full-time basis. His family's been very supportive of this. Mr. Matusiak has cooperated with authorities at full steam. He's done everything possible with the Sheriff's Department. I was there during some statements. He's been honest with me. He has a minimal record. As a matter of fact, the only record it shows was a disorderly conduct in the past. That was a conviction for it. I ask that the court take leniency on my client, as he's lost a great deal on this matter. I understand the presumption in this matter is towards a prison term, but Mr. Matusiak paid a great price today, even before he's sentenced by this court.
Mr. Matusiak, do you have anything to say before the court pronounces sentence?
Well, I made a stupid statement. I'm paying dearly for it, a little more than my family.
Well, the court has considered the record oral statements and the victim impact statement and pre-sentence report. Prepared as well as the principles and purpose of sentencing and its balance of seriousness and recidivism factors under this code. The court finds the convicted of aggravated arson and felony in the first degree. And in reviewing the pre-sentence investigation report, it appears that we've had one prior adult criminal conviction, which is really a traffic offense or a municipal offense. And you've not been adjudicated a delinquent prior to this offense, although several people have been injured in it, whether directly or indirectly through your actions, and what you're suffering for it now. So it's going to be the judgment and sentence of this court that you be sentenced to 3 years on the aggravated arson charge to the Lorain Correctional Institute in order to pay cost of prosecution for the appointed attorney fees. Well, I've noticed on restitution, my understanding, the statute has changed in that has insurance been paid at all on this?
I don't believe it has, Your Honor. That's the insurees are the co-defendants, so they have not.
That's true, too. So, and I didn't see a restitution form anywhere on here. There's something on here. The undersigned officer's voicemail advised that Liberty Mutual is requesting restitution amount of $76,000. He further advised that the amount is increasing every day. It's my understanding the legislature of the state of Ohio has changed the law and we're not permitted to make restitution back to an insurance company. At least that's why I read them all. So order to pay cost of prosecution, court-appointed attorney fees, and pay the cost of the state fire marshals that I think would be applicable, whatever that amount.
I think that is attached in the deed of
right.